Hello everyone, I'm Roger from NiSi Filters USA, and I'm going to talk about our extended range of graduated neutral density filters. In the 100mm system alone, we have 14 different types to choose from. We also have a wide variety in the 75, 150mm, our cinema line, and our smaller 40mm wide filters. Why so many, you ask? Well, it's to give you control over your image so that you can get it right at the time of exposure, getting it right in camera. Each filter is categorized as either a soft, medium, hard, or reverse graduated filter, and that refers to the length of the transition or the type of transition. Each of these versions come in different densities, which is the amount of light they reduce the exposure by. So now let's go over the four different versions that we have and their use. Let me begin with the soft graduated neutral density filter. A soft grad has a very long or subtle transition from dark to light. And it's perfect when your scene has vertical protrusions rising from the horizon line, such as tall mountains or buildings or trees. The long transition is a subtle change in exposure. The strong light of the sky is tamed, but you'll be able to bring out the details on trees, mountains, or buildings in your photo during post-processing. Next up, we have the medium graduated neutral density filter, which has a much shorter transition from dark to light, allowing for a greater portion of the sky or brighter areas in an image to be darkened, balancing out the exposure. The medium transition allows for small protrusions into the horizon while still retaining image information in the shadows. Distant hills, trees, or buildings will still have enough detail to work with in post-processing. The medium grad is considered to be the most versatile graduated filter. Next up is a hard graduated neutral density filter, which has a very short and distinct transition from dark to light, making it ideal for scenes with a very flat horizon where nothing's sticking out of it, such as the open ocean or a desert scene. The hard graduated neutral density filter perfectly balances the sky and foreground, giving you the most control in post-processing. Next up, we have the reverse graduated ND filter, which actually has dual transition points, one in the center that's the same as a hard grad, but it lightens towards the top, hence the name, the reverse grad. It is used in situations where the light is harshest at the horizon line, but it tapers off towards the sky, allowing you to capture details in the clouds without over darkening the sky. It is usually used at sunrise and sunset, where there is not as much illumination below the horizon line, where the sunlight is strongest. The densities and transition types within a range vary depending on the filter size and model. An ND8 or a 3-stop is the most common graduated filter. However, experience will tell you if you need a lighter or a darker density. All of our available grads can be viewed online at NiSiOpticsUSA.com. I also want to mention the Horizon ND filter. This highly specialized filter has a 4-stop strip of neutral density across the middle of a clear field, and it's best used when the light is strong and direct in one portion of the scene. But it's also best used in combination with either a soft or a medium graduated ND filter, and that will give you the best results. Using our switch filter holder and our graduated ND filters can give you incredible control over your exposure. The switch allows you to individually rotate two separate filters independently. However, I'm going to cover the use of the switch filter holder in a later video. But as you can see, NiSi provides a full set of filters and accessories that help you take images that go beyond imagination.